Hello, you lovely people. It's back. We're doing the whiteboard. It's Wigan tonight that we're covering, or today, when you depend on your watch on this video. So we've got Wigan on Wednesday night live on Sky, as per usual. It's the second part of the preview, which we've got the whiteboard behind us. I'm going to look at Wigan. Now, this lineup, which I'll get out the way, this lineup was the game that they got beat off Aston Villa on the weekend. So if there is to be changes, I don't think there'll be too many. I am expecting Will Grigg to remain on the bench because he hasn't played in the last four or five games. And also, they've got actually Adam Lafondo as well, who hasn't been playing either. They've got Jeskalainen in the goal, who we all know from Wigan as well. Bogdan is obviously injured at the moment, who's on loan from Liverpool, I believe. Looking at that, then let's have a look at their lineups running through it. So this is the last lineup that had Jeskalainen, they had Burke right back, Morgan and Buxton, Neil Warnock, former Premier League left back, McDonald, former Bournemouth midfielder, Garber on the right, Max Power, Perkins, Jacobs and Welsh up front. Right, so this is how they're going to line up. So the first thing that you're going to notice on this lineup, aren't you? Slightly different to the ones that we normally come up against, because they've got four midfielders, but they've also got one who'll sit behind that, which is McDonald as well. So it's going to be very, very, again, this part is going to be very congested, isn't it? So we've got three centre midfielders in there. And then you've also got the two wingers as well. Now, Wigan's strength, as some of you might have seen on the preview that I did at St. James's Park, is down this side. This is their strength. This is where they seem to get a lot of joy from. Warnock, who obviously is not, he doesn't get up as forward as much as what he used to, but now you've got Jacobs up there, who has a license to roam as well, to try and get down the byline and also come in field as well if needs to be as well. So they're very, very strong on that side. I wouldn't say they're weak on that side, but they're just stronger on that side as well. Now, what you'll also find as well, that with Wiltshire up front, which I am surprised that Will Grigg hasn't been playing, because he's got six goals, I believe, this top of my head this season. They don't play long balls. So what you'll find is they'll literally pass and move. They will not, so for example, Warnock won't have the ball and just ping it, wee, long ball, right? Bit over the top exaggeration. But you'll not see none of this, like none of this long ball situation, because obviously we had that against Birmingham, where Birmingham were looking for Clayton Donaldson up top. These will play completely different. They'll try and keep the ball literally on the floor and pass to each other. Simple. They're not Hollywood. Yeah, it's simple. Is it effective? I don't think it is, personally, because if you look at Wigan, they've scored the same amount of goals in the league, 16 and 20, and Dwight Gayle's got 16 and 16. It shows you where the problems are. Maybe they should change the formation up. Maybe they haven't got the personnel. Obviously, they've got a new manager coming in as well. Maybe they'll look at January for some transfer buys as well. What they are particularly good at as well is they're also good at aggression, so they will be literally in your faces as well. They're not very strong in the air, which I feel is a potential tactic, because these guys are not very strong going forward. They don't score many set pieces. I think they've only scored three set pieces off the top of my head, whereas Newcastle have scored 12. Quite a difference, that, you know. Looking at this lineup, I think it's just a matter of if Newcastle controlling the game, just keep an eye on that left wing, and I think we'll be all right, because they're not great in the air. It could be a key that Mitrovic comes on later on, we'll start shouting "Meat Rose on fire" and all of that. But you've got to say Newcastle and the names on there. No disrespect to Wigan, but a lot of them names you probably haven't heard of. No disrespect to some of your fans, but there's some of them who I haven't heard of as well. So all in all, we'll head over to Newcastle now. So, behind us, what I think, not so much what Rafa thinks, this is what I would like to see. Right, so let's have a look at the lineup, what I would like to see this time around, rather than guessing Rafa, because the reason why I'm not guessing Rafa is because there will be changes, and it's so unpredictable in Newcastle what Rafa does, because we've got three games in the space of 7 to 8 days. It's too complicated to predict Rafa's lineup, but this is what I want. So, number 26, Carl Darlow. We'll start on goal. I've gone for Yedlin. I'll come back to that why. Lascelles, Clark, Lazar. Not often I go for Lazar. Hayden, Shelby is the two sitting. Atsu on the left-hand side. Diarmi in the number 10. Gayle up top and Richie on the right-hand side. So let me explain why. Right, you probably noticed that if you look at the fullback straight away, let's have a look at these guys. What do you look at when you look at Lazar and when you look at Yedlin? What's the first thing you think about these two, don't you? You think pace, don't you? Now, the reason why I'm going for these two is because Wigan, especially on the right-hand side, Yedlin's side, are strong on that side. So Yes, I think Anita's better defensively, but this is a game we've got to win, haven't we? We've got to win this game. So I'm going to go for Yedlin because you know he'll bomb on, won't he? I might as well use the black arrow since I'm honest. Lazar, the reason why I haven't gone for Dummett is because Dummett has been playing a lot of games, and if you rest Dummett and bring Lazar in for this one, I think Dummett away from Burton Albion is better than Lazar option because it's a very tight ground. We're going to be under a lot of pressure, even though it's Burton Albion. So I'm going to go for Lazar. So Lazar will have a license to get forward as well, which will trouble Garbutt if Garbutt plays on the right hand side for Wigan, which will allow then Atsu, these two, can imagine these two going forward. I know it's a bit risky because you've got both of those guys are very, very attacking. Maybe you might go for Gouffran here instead if he plays Lazar there, just for the better safe option. But this is kind of like an all-out attack on the left-hand side there, isn't it? Looking at the right-hand side, we know Richie. I don't think Richie would be dropped. I think Richie's a certainty. Well, we talk about Richie almost every game now. We know what he can do. We know what he brings. He's more hit than miss. He has gone missing a few times this season, but all in all, he's had a good season so far, a solid season. I think Hayden, who had a great game. I was kind of disrespectful. I was on 40s fan cams and I only give him a 7. I've changed my mind. I think I'll give him an 8 looking back and reflecting on it. So I think Hayden, but it wouldn't surprise me if the likes of Colback just comes in, because I have said it numerous times. I think personally for me, Colback's better away from home than what Hayden is. So that wouldn't surprise me too much with these. Shelby, the man. Now, when I said it in the previous tactic board video, I obviously got the goals right coming down that Birmingham were weak on the width, and the battle would be won on the wings, which it was. Today, on the last tactic board, I said Shelby needs to get forward, and he did. He got forward. He obviously got a couple of assists bursting forward, which we need to see more of. We need to see more of it. So Shelby, a great game last time out. Keep it up. We know you can spring these wonderful balls as well. I think it's a little bit more. I'm not going to encourage him to push forward too much because it's a risk having these guys bombing on left, right, and centre. This man against his old club. Remember, I used to play for Wigan. Remember when he scored against us at St James' Park for Wigan? That little pile driver outside the box. Outstanding last game. Best game, me personally, that I've seen him play in Newcastle shirt. Yes, he scored a couple of goals against Preston, but he's kind of you didn't see much of the game. This game, he was literally nicking the ball back. He was aggressive. He was running. He's running from deep, running attackers. He literally reminded me of Tino Asprey back in the day, minus the skills. So Diarmi, for me, you kind of drop him. If he drops Diarmi and brings in Perez, that's really harsh on the lad. I would like to see Diarmi start. Dwight Gayle, I have said that obviously Wigan are weak in the air, which leaves probably Mitrovic later on. But I know Mitrovic is probably getting frustrated, but his time will come. He might start on Saturday against Burton, but for me, you kind of drop this lad. Hat-trick 16-16, how can you? I know you might say, oh well, let's play two up top, but not for me. Not this. Keep this for the time being. He needs this guy. Diarmi needs a run of games. That's he needs to now say, right, I'm here, command this position. I'm going to step up to the plate. That's what I want from Diarmi. That's what I want. We know what Gayle needs. I said this last game. This area, he loves this area. And it was Shelby who got him the goals as well. And more Diarmi with his crosses, getting in the crosses as well. So again, service. Give Gayle service, he'll score as well. I'm going to go for a 2-0 victory for Newcastle. Let me know what you think of the score predictions. The team, what do you want? Do you want like Dummett here? Do you want Gouffran here? Let us know what you think of what you guys want in your comment section down there below. And it's live on the sky. And obviously, I'll be doing the review outside St James's Park after the game. Right, thanks very much for watching. See you later.